Hi guys, it's Mike, back for another little bit of Space Engineers. I'm going to make this a map wrap-up scenario at the moment. We're going to be wrapping things up, and I'll go over quickly what we've learned in these four episodes now. In episode one, Arrival, you find out your start position, your assets, mainly this repainted big blue ship, and you get a drone, because there's very little iron in the sector, it's totally mined out, so getting started is a pain in the ass, to be honest. It's very, very hardcore. In episode 2 I show you how I've moved all the asteroid round, played with the ratios of ore, and set up 3 targets to be attacked by yourselves. Unfortunately, it's come to my attention on the forum that Space Engineers has kind of broken SE Toolbox, or it's got something to do with the way that Keenhouse software saved the files for the asteroids, the information for them. Apparently Midspace are saying that SE Toolbox no longer recognizes the ores and any adjustments you've made to the ores don't seem to correspond now to what's happening in the game. For instance, my ore detector is telling me there's a shit ton of iron in this asteroid. When I get the drill out, it's showing iron all over the place, but it turns out it's cobalt and magnesium and not iron. So there you go, you're going to get a lot of false readings on your drill. And I did find some iron and it didn't show up on the drill, so that's going to be a problem. I might have to rework the map with, you know, take out all the asteroids that I adjusted with Midspace's SE Toolbox and replace them with bog standard Keenhouse software asteroids. But I don't know how that's going to go. If I do update the map, you probably won't notice. It will just come through as an update, and then, like, you know, you can download and play as normal. In episode 3 we talked a little bit about what you're going to need to set up a base, and also I discussed the fact that you can't destroy the ship. This ship has to stay in one piece in order for you to win the scenario. You have to take over Mine Core with what you've got. So you're going to need to attack enemy ships. I also talked a little bit about the Invader mod. There's fighters that are going to come at you regular, and they're no joke. I'll show you a picture here of this is the big red ship after I tangled with one of the fighters during testing. I think I hit one of the sensors and it did a bit of a death spiral and slammed into the ship at 104 meters per second. And it's, you know, if one of them slammed into this is quite weak. It's not made of heavy armor, except in the places where I've modified it and added a few bits. So yeah, there you go. With those 3 episodes, there's everything you need to know about this map. And I'll continue playing, like maybe 20-minute episodes of me just doing my survival world where I won't have to explain anything. I might sort of recap a little bit the fact we're playing a world from Steam. So yeah, it's available on Steam. It comes down as, if you put in Invader mod, you should come up with this and the base defense scenario. Personally, I think the base defense scenario is better for newer players. This is more of a experienced players only. Unfortunately, it's not for noobs, because if you don't know what you're doing, this ship's gonna die and everything's gonna just go wrong for you, to be honest. You know, there's no way I think you could play this scenario without knowing Space Engineers in and out, because you have to rely on all those little tricks of the trade, like disassembling, and you're going to need to know a little bit about pirating. And the best way to do it as well, I mean, while I was doing my outro for what was going to be the last episode that ended up screwing up during rendering, look, you can see I've lost a thruster, I've lost a few panels here and there, because while I was doing my outro, I forgot I had the guns off. And I was quite happily chatting away inside the ship, and spank, 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 I think we took about 4 hits altogether from meteors. So important to leave your guns on or hide. I mean, I've done empty world pirating, that's quite interesting, with no asteroids at all. But at least in this world you've got somewhere to hide from the asteroids. So there you go. You can modify the ship, but you can't destroy it. You've got to take out the 3 targets to win the scenario. If you attack a private sail, or if you bring a ship back to your base, again, that's a fail. So you've got to learn to get industrial about your grinding. You're going to have to get the drone, repurpose it to grinding, and then use that to make a more effective attack run on your ships. So basically, this map will teach you effective pirating, because you'll either get good at pirating or you'll just die. It's as simple as that. And anyway, that's going to wrap up the map. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and when I come back, it'll just be me doing my normal survival stuff, and also I'll be going on the ASS channel a fair bit, helping with their massive great ship build. You should catch those guys out, Action Soup Studios. And yeah, I'll be doing some other stuff. I'll be doing some DayZ. I've got a whole host of other games that I can try, but I will still keep doing the odd Space Engineers. I might do some, I'm waiting for exploration mode, basically. So as soon as exploration mode comes out, I'll be wrapping up even my survival playthrough, I think, and we'll be going exploring with this same ship. I'll just copy and paste it into another world. Thank God for copy and paste, eh? Plus any modifications. So I'm going to modify it a little bit. I'm going to put a printer chaff launcher that's going to launch a decoy block out the back on the left side, and I'm going to put a printer torpedo launcher on the front as well. So there'll be a couple of modifications I'm going to make to this ship. Should take me quite a while, and I'll for the most part probably do it off camera, but I'll keep you updated as to what I'm doing with it. And if we get a base going, you know, all well and good, but first I've got to find an asteroid with iron in it. Like I say, due to mid-space giving up, basically, Space Engineers have broken SE Toolbox. I mean, they do near enough every patch anyway. Every single patch that Keen have to do, Midspace have to then patch SE Toolbox. And I'm going to be relocating to that donut just over there that has got iron on. I've checked it out, and it's a bit nearer to Mine Core, so I'll be able to do a little bit more aggressive patrolling and maybe take out the blue ship while we're at it. Yeah, I've repaired up what I can with what materials I've got, but we're going to need to do a little bit more attacking, a bit more hijacking first before we can actually, before we're ready for a full-out assault. Yeah, so there you have it, and I'll see you guys around at some point. I'll still be releasing stuff. If you watch my channel, then I've got Kerbal Space Program that I'm doing at the moment. Unfortunately, I'm not one of them sort of people that's really exciting to listen to. I'm not funny. I'm like a very boring Ricky Gervais. So, you know, get Ricky Gervais, take the humour out of him, and you got me. Actually, before I go, I'm just going to give you a quick tour of what sort of damage we took with those meteors. I mean, don't forget, this ship's made of light armor blocks. Might look a bit of a beast, but as I said in episode 1 or 2, she's a light corvette at best. You know, not really designed for going into battle. She's a bit of a civilian ship that's been commandeered. But yeah, we lost all that section there. No damage internal, luckily. Everything stayed intact up here, but we got, oh, ouch. Yeah, and when I downloaded the map or uploaded the map to Steam and then re-downloaded it as a way of moving it from one computer to the other. It put my health back up to 100%. I think it gave me a brand new astronaut. Damn it, because it was really exciting running around on 77% knowing you couldn't make a mistake. Adds to the thrill of it. You know, there's nothing like putting yourself in a situation where you make a mistake and you die. And if you're doing it on camera, that's even more exciting. So yeah, there was no other, there was a bit of minor denting all over the place from Gatling guns, but that's not a problem. As I said, the major damage we took was meteors. Doing my outro. I heard the explosions, I just thought they were hitting the freighter maybe, that we were parked near. But no. One, hit the thruster, two, three, yeah, we took three, possibly four strikes while doing that. That's how quickly you can lose this scenario. Just one mistake and you're done. Just one mistake. Can you play Space Engineers without making a mistake? Yeah, well, unfortunately, I would have... To be honest, if it weren't for Space Engineers being so chronically crashy just lately, I mean, during one take that I was trying to do... well, during the attack on the freighter, actually, it crashed four times. And I had to do, like, almost four different takes to get it done, and yeah, they've hot fixed it now. It seems to be more stable now, even if it is just a little bit more laggy than it used to. They've fixed the assemblers, and you know, I'm all in favour of them fixing stuff up, especially multiplayer. Multiplayer is abysmal at the moment. I don't play a hell of a lot of it, you know, but I do join the odd server now and again for my own private amusement. So, yeah, there you go, guys. We're going to wrap it up, and you've seen the damage, and what am I doing? Oh, yeah, gravity's upside down. Sorry, gravity's upside down, because I was playing around with that asteroid, trying to dig a bit of ore. Well, I'll get used to it. There's no up and down in space anyway. What are you talking about? There is no up and down. Storm inbound. Right, so anyway, guys, oh, peace out, and I'll catch you later. But I'll try and bring you some more varied stuff on my channel. And I'll try and bring you a little bit more Space Engineers when it's fixed properly, alright, guys? And, yeah, sorry for the delay in this. And sorry there's not much in this episode. It's just I was wrapping the map up, basically. That's all this is. And anything you see from now on is just normal survival play. So, I mean, it's been a pain in the arse, to be honest, just like role-playing this map from the perspective of somebody that doesn't know what's going on. You know, you try all the usual stuff, put some plates down, build a base, salvage a bit of the ship. You can take the doors off, because that's an improvement, but, you know, you're stuck with not disassembling it. It's not the yellow starter ship. It's a bit bigger, and you've got to get used to handling big ships. So, and one tip I recommend that you do, if you can, is group together. Ah, damn it, that grouping's gone. I had my gyros grouped together. It seems to have disappeared itself. But basically, group all the gyros together, and then you have a button that switches on and off the gyro override, and then use gyro override to throw the ship about. It's the only real way of moving big ships, or else you'd be sitting there scrolling your mouse all fucking day. So yeah, group the gyros and use gyro override to throw the ship around. She spins and goes end over end remarkably quick. If you've ever played around with gyro override, it is the only way to move a big ship. I'm telling you that now. There's no other real way of doing it. So anyway, guys, again, I'll see you later.